Hey, what's going on, guys? PSV here, and welcome to a new little, it's not really a series, it's a new little video what I'm going to be posting on my channel quite often. So this is called the Euro Truck Simulator 2 mod review. So I'm not going to say how often it's going to be, hopefully once a week I'm going to be making a video reviewing a mod of a modded truck or even a modded map or something within the game of Euro Truck, just so you guys do get a bit more of an understanding of all the different mods that are out there for this game. As you all know, this game is very highly moddable, so there are hundreds, or should we just say thousands, of different mods you can get for this game, some being absolutely poor, some being absolutely brilliant. So how's this series going to work? I call it a series because it's going to be several parts to it, just all different trucks. Let's just stick with a series, it's probably not, but you know. So how's this series going to work? So basically I'm going to pick a mod out of a list I've got quite a few lined up, and then I'm going to show you all the customizations and what you can do with the truck and what new features you've got, what you don't get within the game. And then once I've done all the review, I'll pick up a load and take it for a tiny little drive. I will not be doing the whole distance, I'll just literally just show you how it pulls and stuff, because this is just obviously a review of the truck, not a journey. And then once I've done all that, at the very end I'll give it a rating out of 10. Like, I'll give them stars, out like 10 out of 10, and so on. As you can get the gist, I'm kind of rambling on a little bit now. So without further ado, let's jump in and review this truck. Okay, before we head over and see what upgrades there is compatible with this mod, let's have a look at the bodywork itself. So as you can see, it's the Volvo vt880, and it's a Globetrotter. Extra large as well. It has got a long nose on the front as well, as you can see there. So let's just take a nice little look. Yeah, it does look quite nice, I'm not gonna lie, with my female driver. It does look a nice little truck. Got quite a big chassis at the back. I guess the curtains in the window look pretty tacky, but yeah, overall the outing don't look too bad. Let's drive it over and to the customization place and see what upgrades we can do. Let's listen to the start of the engine first. So yeah, it's got quite a nice smooth basic sound to it. Perhaps it could be a bit more beefier, the sound to the engine when starting it up, but no, I guess that's okay. So here we are, guys, we are now in the truck configuration place where you can do the upgrades to your truck. So let's go along and have a look. So see, there's only one cabin available for this truck. I'm not too fussed about that, because the cabin's how it is. That's where you got the mod, nice cabin like that. Let's move over to chassis. This is where I guess they could have put a couple of chassis in option here. Maybe not, but again, I'm not too fussed about that. I would have selected the 6x4 chassis anyway. What's that? What's fine like that? Maybe they could have added the new, where you can get the wheels lift, like the tug lifts on there. Maybe they could have added that within this mod, like you have got on the new update 1.14, I do believe, where they've added that. I did review that on the DAF on my channel. If you haven't seen that, head over to there. Let's have a look at the engines. So we have got several engines that we have got. We've got five here. Starting off at 540 horsepower, all the way down to 1,500 horsepower. That's too much. That's stupid, I think. It's a big glory to pull, but I think people like all big engines and stuff, but I like to go for a tricky. So I think 700's okay. I would personally, if I wanted a big challenge, I'd knock it down to either 600 or 540. But that's just personal opinion. People think different. Transmissions, again, you've just got your two. This is where I'm a bit gutted about. Normally you get the option to move it over to, like, obviously it's left hand drive, but you can move it over to right hand drive. But on this one you've only got one selection, and normally you can change the interior as well, but there's no adjustments there. Obviously we've got our nice little iPhone there, packet of cigarettes with a lighter there. Anything else? No. There's nothing really... Yeah, this one's a bit boring inside, I guess. So obviously here we're at the colour. We can customise the colour of your truck. Let's have a look. So obviously 2013 is that blue that we've got now. We can put it on stormy blue. Put it on sunlight silver. That looks okay, apart from it looks like it's been scratched a bit. I don't particularly like that. Black Knight. I think that's quite nice. Quite like the Black Knight. Obviously we've got that greeny colour as well. I think for this one I'm going to select the Black Knight. I quite like that. So, don't all jump at once for excitement. But the customisations for the accessories is pretty poor. You've got your bulk standard where you can change your tyres. Yep. You get that on every mod. You do get some ones that do come with the mod. Some tyres, but I think they look pretty naff. I quite prefer them ones like that. So yeah, and then we can change the mirrors, but we only get one option, so we can't change the mirrors at all. And the same with that one. Okay, that's pretty poor. Let's have a look in the interior, see what accessories we can add. Again, that's just going to be for the mirror, so we can't adjust nothing inside. I wish there was an option to get rid of these curtains, or to change the colour of the curtains. Okay, well, that's pretty bulk standard. Let's head out of this. Back into our truck. Let's just get rid of that. I guess that don't look too bad. Just changed the colour. There's not really much of configurations that we could have done. But yeah, let's go and pick up a load and see how this truck pulls. Okay guys, so here we are. We've just picked up a trailer. And I just noticed something while driving this lorry to the place to pick up the trailer. To the depot where I'm picking up the trailer. The turning circle on this Volvo lorry is absolutely appalling. Oh my god. For a lorry, let's show you what I mean. Okay, so we're turning out of here, okay? Okay, let's just make sure it's clear, obviously. Yeah, all looking good. Okay, I'm trying to show you a situation. I don't think we're going to come across one where the turning circle is so bad. I need to go to somewhere where it's quite tight. But I was in quite a wide car parking area, and literally I thought, oh, let's try the turning circle. I tried it, and I've honestly have never seen something so poor. Well, anyway, let me just show you what this is basically like. So it pulls, it does pull nicely. Obviously bigger engines are going to pull better, so it does pull quite nice. All quite close there. So yeah, it does pull very nicely, to be honest with you guys. Oh god, rolling backwards. Put it in the right gear, PSV. So we get stuck behind this red light again. So yeah, no, it does pull nicely. It's this turning circle. It is absolutely terrible. Okay guys, so what I've done, I kind of skipped in the video a little bit just to give you an idea of what this turning circle is like. So I've headed over to the garage, as you can see. Oh, wrong button, PSV. As you can see here, we've headed over to the garage. Now let's try and turn this truck around. I bet ya I can do it first time this time. Alright, so we turn it here. Let's put the full lock steering on. Okay, any other truck, this should spin around fine. Look at how much room that is using. I've got to stop because obviously we've got the long nose as well. I'm going to have to reverse it. See, checking the mirrors as well. And I bet even this nudge with full lock on is not going to go round. No, it's not having it. So I wanted to just show you what that full lock was like, what the turning circuit was like. I just wanted to put that in the video. I think that's quite a great little feature to have within the video, because it's a big part of the truck. And that could put a lot of people off, and I can tell you for a fact that has put me off. Of not off of the truck, of driving it, I will still drive it, but that has knocked my ending, like my final grading down. Let's turn the engine off. Let's step outside this truck. And I think it's about time we wrapped up this video. So obviously these videos aren't going to be overly long. I'm only briefly going over all the mods, and giving it my own opinion. I will just say that, I know I'm going to get people being like, oh no, it's not this, it's that. But we all have our own opinions on these mods, and all these videos are just my own briefly opinion. And, you know, everyone's entitled to their own opinion. So let's give it a final rating. I'm going to final rate this, I say 5.5 out of 10. Yes, I'm giving it a low percent, not a low percentage, a low grading, about halfway. I say 1 because it got quite a few points due to the fact I like the look of it, and it does sound nice. It lost marks from the turning circle big time, and the lack of customization there was with to the truck. So yeah guys, I hope you all enjoyed this video. There will be many more of these videos to come, as well as me just doing some basic journeys with the old G27 and or Euro truck. So if you did enjoy this video, please ensure to give it a thumbs up. Link to this mod will be down in the description for any of you that wanted to try this out yourself. And without further ado, keep safe. Happy trucking.